हे रंब हरे जय हे रंब हरे, 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 जय दुर्गा हरे जय जय दुर्गा 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 हरे, जय शिव हरे जय जय शिव हरे, जय शिव हरे जय जय शिव हरे, जय शिव हरे जय जय शिव हरे, जय शिव हरे शिव शंकर हरे, जय विष्णु हरे जय जय विष्णु 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 हरे, आदित्य हरे जय आदित्य 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 हरे, जय राम हरे जय जय कृष्ण 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 हरे, हो जपा कर यही नाम मन बवरे, 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 जय राम हरे जय जय कृष्ण हरे, जय राम हरे जय जय कृष्ण हरे, जय राम हरे जय जय कृष्ण हरे।
Devotees, what we have done here constitutes your puja. You make your offerings in this way. Even when you have to perform your puja, you may not know all the mantras of Avahan and Asan, but simple. Ganesh Baba, Avahayami, Sthapayami, Pujayami. Oh Lord, I want you to let your presence be felt by me in this particular spot. I want to worship you. I'm consecrating you. And you make all the simple offerings. Pushpam Samarpayami, flowers, water. Ashmanam samarpayami, osnanam samarpayami, naivedyam samar, simple. And at the end of it all, as we just did, you don't have to learn any long technical Sanskrit mantras, you know. Puja, भाव. As Bhagwan said in the Gita, it is not what you offer, but the attitude with which you offer it, the love. So whatever you know in simple way, Jai Krishna Hari, Jai Krishna Hari, Hey Ramb Hari, Hey Ramb is another name of Lord Ganesh. Aditya Hari, you know, Vishnu Hari, simple mantras. If you know more, you can say it. But this is what a puja constitutes, simple. And if you can do more, as I said, then you do more, which is what we are going to do now. So, I want us to let us glorify Devi Ma. And we will do it collectively as we normally do it at times. The Bhavani Ashtakam, which is a very, very powerful stotra. And what we are doing, we are surrendering ourselves to Devi, as we say. Devi, who is Devi? As we have maintained time and again, Devi is the personification of energy. This whole world is energy vibrating at different frequencies. Hinduism identifies the different energies we have personified, these different powers. So we have explained time and again, Durga Ma, Lakshmi Ma, Saraswati Ma, Ichha Shakti, Gyan Shakti, Kriya Shakti, Kali Ma, Kal, time, Kali, power of time, time personified. All these different devis as such represent certain powers personified. No man can function without energy. Not even a blade of grass could move without energy. This is why Hinduism tells us, worship the Devi, the mother, so to speak. But there is also a psychological dimension to this. We have the mother aspect to worship. Hinduism has the father aspect. You know, we are told, Tvameva mata cha pita, Tvameva, Tvameva bandhu sa sakha, Tvameva. Different relationships. Why? Again, because of our own temperament. You know, in society today, we have some who cannot and never ever will relate to our father. Think about it. Many children have been abused by their fathers. So you have a child being abused badly in all forms by a father. And you are telling that child to pray to God as God is father. When the child detests the term father, the image of father, how could that child pray to father? Think about it. This is why Hinduism is the most psychological religion in the world. It allows you to function where you are comfortable. It doesn't impose upon you, as all other religions do. Not condemning them, but this is what they do. All other religions say God is father. And you hate a father, but you have to worship God as a father. Hinduism says no. God is a mother. Who is God? What is God? He is infinite. How I go to him, so he comes to me. So if I want to worship God as a mother, that concept is in Hinduism. Some people never got parental love. They understand what a friend is. Sakha, Sakya Bhav. Hinduism allows you that. Some people very close to a beloved, Madhurya Bhav. Hinduism allows you that if you can't follow the others. As a matter of fact, Hinduism even allows the man who cannot love, but who could hate intensely. Like Ravan, like Kans, Vidvesh Advesh Bhav. You hate someone intensely, that person is in your mind day and night. Bhagwan says, think of me constantly. So even the man who can't show love, but more intense hate, if he hates with such a passion, even he could find God. As a man think it, so he become it. A rare case. But Hinduism allows even that man the opportunity. Doesn't ostracize any. And if a person is an atheist, he doesn't even believe in God, then don't tell me you don't believe in all this energy that exists. Hinduism caters even for him who want to believe in a formless. There's nothing like form, there's nothing like a God, but there's some superpower. So Hinduism caters even for such a person. So devotees, if you understand these concepts, where are you going? This is the ocean. You see right here. But if you can't find God, it is not God's fault. It is not God's problem. It is our problem. Now we have not identified where we are going. Who is God to me? Lackadaisical, lazy. And in devotions, there is no room for laziness. So devotees, we concentrate on the energy aspect of divinity. mother. So even if a person can't relate to a mother, but you understand energy, so you need energy. So you can still worship, as the case may be. I want to become one with that divine energy. Gatishtvam, gatishtvam, tvameka bhavani. This is your line, which you're going to say twice. So we concentrate on the divine. Na tato na mata, na bandhur na data, na putro na putri, na bhrityo na bharta, na jaya na vidya na vrittir mameva. Bhavabhav pare maha dukha bhiru, papata prakami prarobhi pramattaha, ku sansara pasha pravadha sadaham. Na janami danam na cha dhyana yogam, na janami tantram na cha stotra mantram, na janami pujang na cha nyasa yogam. Na janami punyang, na janami tirtham, na janami muktim layang va kadachit, na janami bhaktim vratang vapi matar. Kukarmi, kusangi, kubudhi, kudasaha, kulacharahina, kadacharalina, kudrishti, kuvakya, prabandha, sadaham. Prajesham, Ramesham, Mahesham, Suresham, Dinesham, Nishitheshwaram, vakadachit, najanami, channa, sadaham, sharanye. Vivade vishade pramade pravase jale chanale parvate shatru madhye aranye sharanye sadamang prapahi. Anato daridru jara roga yuktu mahachina dina sadajadya vaktra vipattav pravishtah pranashtah sadaham. Iti Sima Shankaracharya Kritam Bhavan Ashtakam Sampurnam. Om Jayanti Mangala Kali Bhadrakali Kapalini Durga Chama Shiva Dhatri Swaha Swadha Namostute Jai Tvam Devi Chamunde Jai Bhutarthi Harani Jai Sarva Gate Devi Kal Ratri Namostute. Be joined.
जग की रखवाली करने वाली जगदम्बे मैया, महिमा तुम्हारी है निराली ओ जगदम्बे मैया। दुखी रखवाले करने वाले जगदम्बे मैया, तेरे दया से जीते हैं मैया, तेरे भरोसे चलती है मैया। तेरे भरोसे चलती है मैया, के घर घर में है दीवानी जगदम्बे मैया। सखियों के घर में सुख बरसाए, अंधियारी घर में दिया जला दे, अंधियारी घर में दिया जला दे, राति खाली जगदम्बे मैया, चरणों में बैठे आश लगाए, विनती हमारी खाली न जाए, चरणों में बैठे आश लगाए, विनती हमारी खाली न जाए, विनती हमारी खाली न जाए, रेणू ये आती की खाली जगदम्बे मैया,
आर शक्ति जगदम्बा माता की जाए। डिवोटीज, एंड नाउ वी विल कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन भगवान शंकर। वी हैव रेकमेंडेड टाइम एंड अगेन द महामृत्युंजय मंत्र, विच इज वेरी वेरी नेसेसरी, इम्पोर्टेंट, रेलेवेंट इन टुडेज वर्ल्ड, एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट फॉर ऑल टाइम्स। द मृत्युंजय मंत्र, वन ऑफ द फाइव मंत्रस गिवन टू अस फ्रॉम श्री महापुराण, विच इज एम दैट प्रोटेक्टिंग अस from all negativities. So that mantra, simply everybody should learn that mantra, everybody should chant it, even the children, and on a daily basis recite this mantra: Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urvarukam Iva Bandhanan Mrityor Mukshiyamamritat. Everybody can become a victim at any point in time, anywhere, even in your own homes. We need protection. And history has it, time and again, when evil forces were rampant, and even those who were empowered to protect and serve, even they became victims. So then what can you do? This is why time and again the scriptures say, when such circumstances arose, the devotees appeal to that divine intervention, spirituality. But you know what? We shouldn't wait for such circumstances only to appeal to divinity. It should become part of our daily prayer. So I want to strongly recommend that we all learn this mantra properly and even teach it to the children. They're not too small to learn it. And everybody should chant this mantra on a daily basis. On a daily basis. The worship of Shiva is very, very necessary. Now, Shiva, that form of divinity, symbolizes the state of Tyag. We say Tyag, to let go. To let go. Now, you will all readily agree with me that one of the most difficult things to do in this world is to let go. To let go. We all cling on in so many different ways. It becomes almost impossible to let go. I keep saying, even when we put aside the time to pray to God, even that point in time, we still can't let go of so many things otherwise. We are really caught up. And when problems come, we expect to get solutions. How? We have explained time and again, according to Ramayana, when they want to trap a monkey, what they do? They put a glass jar with a wide base, thin, long, narrow neck. And in that glass jar, they place a laddu, a balata, something to attract the eyes of the monkey. They would secure this jar on the ground, hunters would, they would remain in hiding. Monkey would be searching for something to eat. And he would see this balata in there, through the glass jar, and he has enough sense to pick it up. So with open palm, his hand would go down into the jar and hold on to the laddu. But now, the laddu in his fist tied, the hand can't come out. It can't come out. He will jump up and down, I am caught, I am caught. And the question is asked, is he really caught? What does a monkey have to do to get away? What does he have to do? Let go. Let go. He doesn't let go, and he's caught. Whose fault is it? And Vedanta tells us this is how man behaves. He holds on to the laddu of materialism. Anything, anything, mostly material things you grab onto. Very few grab onto spiritual things and don't let go. We let go bhajan, we let go temple, we let go worship, we never let go rum drinking, we never let go liming, you know, all these negative things, we never let go. But things that help us in life, we let go those things. Jhoot, natyag, you don't give up lies, dishonest, no, these things you don't give up. You give up praying, you give up worshipping. These things are very easy to give up. Isn't that so? Now, devotees, this Vedanta tells us we behave like the monkey. We grab onto these things. We are trapped. We are in pain day and night. We want to be free, but we don't want to let go. And the solution is to let go. Now, if you ask yourselves, all of us, those of you who are here listening, everything else, ask, all of us are caught up somehow. Some may have serious problems right now. And the solution may simply be, let me let go. Take a step back. And I am free. But I can't let go. I don't want to let go. Hinduism has put to us this concept of Tyag through Bhagwan Shankar. And through ritualistic worship, focusing on Shivaji, we develop the power of Tyag to let go. We can let go. And letting go doesn't mean I let it go physically, but it's in my mind. It means psychologically you sever all ties. As the saying goes, you don't change the scenery, you change the vision. You have to let go psychologically from the head inside. And this is where our problem lies. And I want you to ask yourselves, when situations confront you, is it that I can let go of something and be free? Is it that I'm clinging on too much so I'm causing pain to myself? And more likely than not, this is where your solution lies. In the analysis, whether you're caught up or not, whether you're free or not. And you know, the problem with society is that this is mind-the disease also. When the situations arise, problems arise, we always think that somebody has done this to us. You know, that's a favorite thing in society today. Everything is spirit, everything is obia, everything is these negative things. Negative things, and we pray to God every day. What sense does that make? Mind-the disease, mind-the sickness. We need to free ourselves. When I worship Shiva, the concept of Tyag, we get rid of this mind disease and we can let go very easily. Easier said than done. Easier said than done. But remember, a solution has been given to you. But rather than let go, many people cling on more and more. Cling on more and more. It is to your detriment. And you know what? We want freedom. Freedom of body, but entrapment of the mind, of the soul, so to speak. This is the problem with society. We want freedom to do anything we want, say anything we want, drink anything we want, freedom of the body. But remember Gandhiji said, I prefer to enchain the body, but free my mind. But the problem is, the mind is in chains, even though the body is free. How could you be happy? How could you be? Okay? And analyze the devotees. Rather than free ourselves like a quicksand, in quicksand, we are sinking more and more rather than getting out of it. The journey is to free oneself. And Hinduism tells us, through the worship of Shiva, this becomes possible. It becomes easier. So devotees, we concentrate on Bhagavan Shankar. And we do the Mahamitrunjaya Stotram. And this is for the protection of all. Remember your line? Namami Shirsa Devam Kinno Mrityuhu Karishyati. You will recite this. You are making prostrations of Mrityunjaya Bhagavan. You are identifying with him. You are tapping into that power inside of you. You want to be free from bondage. So, if you really want to be free from bondage, focus and do it right. This is Mansik Puja or Vachik Puja that we are doing. That has a Mansik dimension. Om Asasi Mahamrityunjaya Stotra Mantrasya Sri Markandeya Rishi Anushtup Chandha Sri Mrityunjaya Devata Gauri Shakti Mama Sarvadishta Samasya Mrityu Shanti Artham Sakal Aishwarya Prapti Artham Cha Jape Vini Yoga Ata Dhyanam Chandra Ark Agni Vilochanam Smriti Mukham Padma Dvayantaha Sthitam Mudra Pasha Mrgaksha Sutra Vilasat Panin Himangshu Prabham Kotindu Pragalap Sudhapa Lutatanum Harabi Hushojvalam Kanti Vishwa Bimohanang Pashupating Mrityunjayam Bhavayit Om Rudram Pashupating Sthanum Nilakantham Umapatim Nilakantham Kal Murti Kalagyam Kalanashanam Nilakantham Virupaksham Nirmalam Nilaya Prabham Vamadevam Mahadevam Lokanatham Jagadgurum Deva Devam Jagannatham Devesham Vrishabhadhvajam Gangadharam Mahadevam Sarvabharna Bhushitam Anathah Paramanandam Kaivalya Padagaminam Swarg Apavarga Dataram Srishti Shiti Vinashakam Utpati Shiti Sanghar Kartaram Ishwaram Gurum We say the Mitrunjaya mantra in your minds. Om Markandeya Kritam Stotam Yapathe Shiva Sannidhau Tasya Mrityu Bhayam Nasti Nagni Chaur Bhayam Kvachit Shatavatam Prakartabhyam Sankate Kashta Nashanam Shuchir Bhutva Pathet Stotam Sarva Siddhi Pradayakam Mrityunjaya Mahadev Trahi Mam Sharanagatam Janma Mrityu Jara Rogahe Piritam Karma Bandhanahe Tavatastvat Gata pranas tvachittu ham sadam rida iti vigyapaya devesham trayam vyakhya manum japet om namah shivaya sambaya hare paramatmane pranata klesha nashaya yoginang pataye namaham om hrim shrim hrim hrim hra hanahan dahadah pachapach ग्रहान ग्रहान मार्य मार्य मर्दय मर्दय महा महाभैरव भैरव रूपेण धुनय धुनय कंपय कंपय विघ्नय विघ्नय विशेश्वर क्षोभय क्षोभय कटु कटु मुहय हुंफत स्वाहा इति मंत्र मात्रेण समाभिष्टो भवति इति श्री मार्कंदेय पुराणे मार्कंदेय कृतं महामृत्युंजय स्तोत्रं संपूर्णम् ओम कर्पूर गौरम करुणावतारम संसार सारम भुजगेन्द्रहारम सदा वसंतम हृदयारविंदे भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय डिवोटीज वी ग्लोरीफाई भगवान शंकर विजुअलाइज The Lord of Nataraj, the Lord of Dance. Dimik dimik dim damaru baje prema magan nachat bhola. As Shri Puran tells us, Bhagwan Shankar plays upon the damaru and he's dancing in a state of ecstasy. Wonderful dance. The damaru symbolizes Lord Shiva possesses what we call the rhythm of manifestation. And just bear in mind, it is said from that damaru emanated what we call the Maheshwar Sutra, the law of creation. Everything emanates out of that sound vibration created by the damaru. The Maheshwara Sutra, very, very deep. At some point in time, we'll elaborate more. But for now, we're all caught up in the cycle of time, cycle of birth, cycle of death. Notice dance represents cycle, the damaru, cycle. Everything is cyclical. We're all caught up in that cycle. But what we need to do is to put ourselves in sync with that divine cycle. How could you go on? Visualize Shiva ji. Bambhola. Shiva Bambhola. Put the hearts into it.
Dimika dimika dim damru bhaje prema maghan na chat bhola. दिमिक दिमिक दिम दमरू बाजे प्रेम मगन नाचत भूला प्रेम मगन नाचत भूला प्रेम मगन नाचत भूला Bambhola Shiva Bambhola Bambhola Shiva Bambhola Bhala Chandra Shira Ganga Laharat Adabh Bhutan Kubhola Bhala Chandra Shira Ganga Laharat Adabh Bhutan Kubhola To Dimik Dimik Dim Dam Rubhaje Prema Maghan Nachat Bhola हे प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला बंभोला शिव बंभोला बंभोला शिव बंभोला बोलो सिंगी नाद बजावत गावत लत की रहियो बगली झोला सिंगी नाद बजावत गावत लत की रहियो बगली झोला तो दिमिक दिमिक दिम दमरू बाजे प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला हे प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला बम भोला शिव बम भोला बम भोला शिव बम भोला बोलो नागपनन शोकरत आरती देव देव गति अनमोला नागपनन शोकरत आरती देव देव गति अनमोला तो मिकदिमदम रूपाजे प्रेम मघन नाचत भोला प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला शिव बंभोला बंभोला शिव बंभोला बोलो हे प्रेम मगन नाचत भोला हे बंभोला शिव बंभोला बंभोला शिव बंभोला बम भोला शिव बम भोला हे बम भोला
Devotees, if you can hold that image of Shivaji dancing, that anahat nad, dimik dimikadim, dimik dimikadim. If you go deeper and deeper, that subtle sound, you can become one with that vibration through the kirtan, vachik types of puja. Devotees, focus. Focus.
Om dimika dimika dim dimika dimika dim naache bhola nahat Om dimika dimika dim naache bhola nahat नाचे भोला नाथ ओ नाचे भोला नाथ ओ नाचे भोला नाथ ओम धिमिक धिमिक धिम नाचे भोला नाथ मृदंग बोले शिव 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 ओम मृदंग बोले शिव 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 ओम डमरू बोले हर 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 हे डमरू बोले हर 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 दीना बोले हरिओम शिव ओम शिव 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 ओम हरिओम शिव ओम दीना बोले शिव 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 नाचे भोला नाथ ओ नाचे भोला नाथ ओ नाचे भोला नाथ ओ नाचे भोला नाथ ओ नाचे भोला नाथ ओम धिमिक धिमिक धिम धिमिक धिमिक धिम नाचे भोला नाथ ओम धिमिक धिमिक धिम धिमिक धिमिक धिम नाचे भोला नाथ ओ धीमे कधी मे कधी धीमे कधी मे कधी
Devotees, this type of puja, kirtan, vachik, is very, very powerful. Chauthi bhakti mama guna ganak kare kapata tajigan. Bhagavan Sri Ram explained to Shivari in Sri Ram, Amcharitamanas, the fourth stage in bhakti is to sing his glories with a guileless purpose, just to please him. Sincere, genuine. There's a power in chanting the name. So vachik form of puja is also very, very powerful if done properly. So devotees, I'm mentioning all these because we need to make all these things part of our daily lives. Now puja, let me explain simply. Many believe that puja is when you sit at the bedi. And I'm saying no, no. Puja, two syllables, pa-ja. Pa-pap-nashan. Destroying sins. Ja, janma vichhed. Crossing over the ocean of duality, birth and death. So any action that burns away sins and frees us from the cycle of birth and death is puja. Now follow me closely. If I sit down on a bedi and I pray, oh God, give me the six numbers, I want to win the lotto because I have this debt to pay and that debt to pay. You're praying for material things. That is going to bind you, isn't that so? Where are you going to win this lotto? In heaven? Where? You have to come back into this world? Then you are not freeing yourself from bondage, birth and death. You are asking to come back into the world. The puja is supposed to free us, as I explained earlier on. Bhut Shuddhi, tap into our inner nature, our true self. But now I'm asking for material things. So rather than free myself, I bind myself further. Then is that puja? According to the definition I have given to you. It's not. And many people use the Vedas, and I'm going to touch upon this at some point in time. They give you, the Vedas tell you, do this yad to achieve that objective. Do that yad to achieve that objective. Devotees, people misconceive, and even great sages misrepresent what the Vedas say. Because if that is what the Vedas say, then the Vedas bind you to this world, which shouldn't be. You have to be freed from the world. Those things have inner meaning. And a big problem we have in our society, that so many people, they take scriptures literally. Follow literally and more materialistic in nature, which shouldn't be. So devotees, what I am saying, life should be like a puja. Everything we do in life should be aimed at freeing us from bondage. How can I free myself from bondage, devotees? How can I burn away sins? We have to act with all the sense of doership. This is where karam yoga comes in. Life is like a flower in full bloom. We should give it away, petals, scent and all, to that garden who brought it into existence. We should not do things selfishly with the expectation of rewards. Then that doesn't free you from bondage. That puts you in bondage. It all goes back to karma. How we perform the karma. The intent behind the karma. And this is why majority of us, I can't speak for everybody, but majority of us, we bind ourselves. Karma is the cause. We do things to bind ourselves. And whereas we are supposed to free ourselves from bondage. You see? So, this is why we are saying, if you perform your actions dispassionately, without expectation of rewards, then you begin to free yourself. You begin to free yourself from bondage. And when karmas are burnt away, you free yourself from the cycle of birth and death. Every action of ours should be like a puja. Life should be like a puja. But is it? Is it? And all because we misunderstand what the puja is supposed to be, inner meaning of it. Now nothing is wrong doing things in the upper level, the superficial level. Yes, until we reach to the point of deeper understanding. You have to do it. We do it. But I'm putting this to you because this is where the ideal is, where we need to go. How to free ourselves from bondage. The reason for all our problems is because we are in the world of duality. We are caught up in the world of duality. You could be here and be free. This is where the Shiva comes in. In the world but not of the world. Satya hai. In the world but not of the world. This is where we need to be. And devotees, everybody looking for happiness. Everybody looking for the freedom. But you're going about it in the wrong way. As Narad Muni once asked Lord Vishnu, Lord, how is it? I can't understand. The funniest thing I see is a human being. Everybody wants to be free, but everybody doing things to go to hell, meaning in bondage. You want to be free. You use even the scriptures to bind yourself further when they're supposed to free you. Think about it, devotees. Think about it. So, I like to put these points for us to think a bit deeper. So when we worship, there's a deeper meaning of worshiping. Because, you know, if I want this and I pray and I get it, when I get it, I stop praying then. Until I want something else. Is that what life is all about? Living on a day-to-day basis? It's supposed to be much, much more than that. Isn't that so? And as I keep saying, you can enjoy a high quality of life by living this type of life, a life of spirituality. You do everything, but you're not caught up. Everything is what takes place inside of here. Inside of here. So devotees, we're all striving for perfection. And it brings me to Bhagwan Sri Ram. We're going to focus on Bhagwan Sri Ram for a few moments, Bhagwan Sri Krishna. Bhagwan Sri Ram represents the state of spiritual perfection. So nothing is done by guess. If you follow Ramayana, Ramayana tells us, you cannot have devotion to Sri Ram unless you are a devotee of Shiva. Philosophically, it implies you cannot go to that state of spiritual perfection unless you let go. Unless there is vairagya, this passion, tyag. So what we do here is a journey. It's a journey. A very beautiful journey. And while I'm at it, when I worship Ganesh Baba, I develop discriminative power, vivek. When I worship Devi, I develop mumukshutva, that intense longing, the yearning to identify with my divine, my true nature. When I worship Shiva, let go, tyag, materialism. I focus upon the divine. When I worship Lord Vishnu, who is Sri Ram, Sri Krishna, sattvic prakriti, the state of piety, lightness and brightness. When I worship Suruj Narayan, the purified intellect. If I don't have the right intellect, I'm confused and deluded in this world of duality. There's a reason for the Pancha Devata, as I explained earlier on. This is why on a daily basis, people worship. Why? Because you want to uncover these beautiful qualities from within you. And let me mention, these qualities are in everybody, without exception. But what do you do to uncover these qualities? That is the question. That is the question. So devotees, Hinduism is so deep. There's a philosophy that underlies everything we do. The modus operandi, that the practice may vary, but the concept, the philosophy doesn't change. And our scriptures tell us time, place, and circumstances, we make adaptations to suit. This is why we have Mansik Vachik Upansu. Mansik Puja, in the mind, circumstances. If you're flying in the plane going to Canada, you can't ring bell and blow sank and do arti. The circumstances don't allow it. You can do Mansik Puja. And even Vachik, you could disturb everybody around. Based upon time, place, circumstances, you choose the type of puja to suit. Our scriptures have given to us all these different formulas that we can apply based upon time, place, and circumstances. Because our scriptures understand that you have people in different circumstances, different places. You know, the conditions are different. You make adaptations to suit where you are. You can't follow everything blindly that India does. Many of us want to believe that. India doing it so. That because of India's social conditioning, cultural position, we are different. Canada is different. Different areas are different. But the concepts don't change. The philosophy doesn't change. The methodology may change. Get clear. This is why I say anyone you can use based upon time, place, circumstances. But some of us are caught up in a time warp and we are scared to make the adjustment adaptations because we feel this is what the book say. The book is written for particular circumstances. We have to understand what the concept is, what the philosophy is. Don't compromise that. But we make the adjustments to suit. So devotee, this is why I'm taking to the level. Sri Ram, spiritual perfection. Shivaji, tyag. Krishna Bhagwan, perfection born out of, ecstasy born out of spiritual perfection. Chronologically, Sri Krishna ki Mata Sri Ram. Why? Only when there is spiritual perfection can one experience divine ecstasy. That is symbolized by Bhagavan Sri Krishna. There's a reason. Everything is a journey in life. You evolve from one point to another. You don't go through the same thing over and over, not knowing where you're going, not achieving anything. If you do the same thing over and over and expect a different outcome, that is referred to as clinical madness. And this is one of the concepts of mind disease. We have a lot of clinically mad people. The survey show one out of every four. I think the survey is wrong. It's approaching three out of every four. Clinically mad. Because we keep doing the same thing over and over and expect to get different results. No. Come on, devotees. You have to wake up. Don't follow blindly. Okay? So we are striving towards spiritual perfection. Where we can, from that step, attain that sphere of experience, Brahmanand, which is what our true nature is. So for a few moments, we glorify Bhagwan Sri Ram. Simple bhajan, we all know it.
Jai Ram Hare, Sri Ram Hare, Bhakton ke dukh dur kare, Jai Jai Sri Ram Hare, O Jai Ram Hare, Sri Ram Hare, भक्तों के दुख दूर करे जय जय श्री राम हरे सब जग में व्यापक हो तुम्हें सब जग में व्यापक हो तुम्हें जग के चराचर नायक हो योगी तेरा ध्यान धरे पापी जनता रे हो तुम बहुत पापी जनता रे हो तुम भक्त जनन के प्यारे हो निर्गुण सगुण रूप रे आप ही के गुण हम गाते हैं जो श्रुति पुराण बताते हो कैसे तुम रावण बधन किए विभीषण अनुचरे देह तिलक विभीषण अनुचरे सीता संग लक्ष्मण भरत मिले अवधपुरी में राज करे जय श्री राम हरे।
राम रामीति रामीति रमे रामे मनोरमे सहस्रनाम तत्तुल्यं श्री राम नाम वरानने। The name Ram, Sri Ram, we go these. Out of the thousands of name of the Lord is the most powerful. Let's chant it.
Hey, Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Oh, Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Hey, Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Oh, Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Hey, Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Hey, Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
Bolir Shri Raja Ramachandra ki jai. And devotees, we glorify Bhagavan Shri Krishna while we make preparations for the final havan. Bhagavan Shri Krishna Lila Purushottam. Visualize him, simple kirtanam. Let's all put our voices together.
Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam. Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda, Radha Ramana Shri Ranga. Hey Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam. Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda, Radha Ramana Shri Ranga. Jai Yadunandana Parama Niranjan. Jai Yadunandana Parama Niranjan. E Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda. E Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda. E Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda. Radha Ramana Shri Ranga. Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam. Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda, Radha Ramana Shri Ranga. Jai Yadunandana Parama Niranjan. Jai Yadunandana Parama Niranjan. E Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda. E Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda. E Radha Ramana Shri Ranga Mukunda. Radha Ramana Shri Ranga. Radha Ramana Hari Govind Jai Jai Gopal Jai Jai Govind Jai Jai. Hey, Radha राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय हे राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय हे राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय हे राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय 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 राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय 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 राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय 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 राधा रमन हरि गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद
बोले वृंदावन श्री कृष्ण चंद्र की जय
ओम जय स्वाहा माता ओम जय स्वाहा माता।